Hi, Rush Nation. Welcome to Rush TV. On today's show, we're back at the home of your Saskatchewan Rush co-op field at Sastel Center. And when we last left off, the Rush had just been dealt a heartbreaking overtime loss by Buffalo right here on home turf. Well, up next, the team would head to sunny San Diego for the first time ever. So now they're
inside. With the Seals riding a three-game winning streak, the Rush were in for a grind out on the West Coast. Nothing they can't handle.
Even the scoring immediately on a goal from Ben McIntosh.
And Ben McIntosh, as we said earlier again, had five goals the last time these two teams met.
How fierce this power play can be. Back outside Matthews, who scores to give Saskatchewan their first lead of the night, their first power play goal. It comes 57 seconds into the penalty.
Nothing more than good ball movement.
Yes,
and
exactly.
And knowing each other.
So the Seals not trailing for the first time. Shot from outside, saved, and front stops with the equalizer.
Mid-season rookie of the year, Austin Stotts, gets the rebound and puts it past Adam Shute. The Rush backup with just his second start of the season. San Diego gets by two more, and it's 4-2 Seals to end the first. Watch this.
Now run out the other way. And the Rush pulled within one.
What a tough break for San Diego. You have a 3-on-2 down at the other end. You hit the pipe, turns into a goal at the other end in transition.
I mean, that is just a good bounce, literally, for Matt Hasek, the defender.
But the Seals continue their first half dominance, scoring twice more before this happens.
Shot clock at 10. Dawson still has it. On the ground, Schultz scores!
Less than a minute left.
Present a run out the other way. Let's see. Thompson has numbers as he hurries ahead. 3-on-2. Shoots and scores. Gorgeous. Nifty. Work there with the stick from Thompson.
Boo all you like. The Rush now trail by 2 at the half.
And moving from right to left in that great black and green combination, and they score immediately into the second half. Just 10 seconds in, they've cut the lead to 1.
Captain Chris Corbeil showing us how it's done. It's his second goal of the season. Seals able to slip in 2 more past Shute before Jeff Shatler finds his target.
And there's an answer from Jeff Shatler.
Little flip by Matthews to Shatler, who just popped up into a shooting spot. Shatler's so talented.
I'd like to think number 77 is trolling the Seals with this dive.
Behind that diving try, and it is in on Chiliano. And Frank immediately expresses his displeasure and said, no way.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised at all if you see a challenge from Patrick Merrill here.
Shatler the goal for a moment.
I think it's a pretty good goal, John.
Yeah, I think he did get inside that top corner on Chiliano, 10-8.
And it's the same move, this time by Ben McIntosh, that'll tie things up at 10.
The Rush score from behind the net, unbelievable.
Defense settling in for this quarter.
A good save by Shute.
But after a goal by San Diego, Curtis Knight steps up for the Rush.
And a goal for the Rush. To pull it within 1, it's Knight. How many seconds later? 20 seconds later.
So the rush answered.
Yeah.
And it's been one of those games where both teams seem to have an answer for each other.
Yes, they do.
In between Dawson and Billings.
And there's a goal. Jackson just fooled Shute on the bouncer, and the lead's back to 2. Mascot Campbell, the veteran, finds a cutter in front, and an answer again from Robert Church. Incredible how the Rush have answered in such quick fashion all night long, and it's back down to 1 with 6:27 to play.
While Shute puts up a solid effort in net, so do the Seals, who deal the Rush their second loss in a row by just 1 goal.
Another huge save.
With more analysis, let's head to the BR Live broadcast booth.
A final score of 13-12. What a night. Seals hold on. They are 2 games up
in the West Division. John Schaefer and Doug Locker. Let's get to the highlights tonight from Pechanga Arena. It started with Dan Dawson's incredible goal.
Dan Dawson twisting and turning and ends up laying on his back and beats Adam Shute.
So not just offense, though. Frank Siciliano in net, especially late, was just outstanding for San Diego.
He was unbelievable. 39 saves on the night for Siciliano. Been a rock for the Seals all year long.
San Diego wins it 13-12. For Doug Locker, I'm John Schaefer.
As you just saw, Rush goaltender Evan Kirk wasn't in net for the San Diego game. He suffered a lower body injury the week before against Buffalo and is now taking it week by week as to when he'll be back. And while the Rush defense has faced adversity this season, one defender is having his strongest showing yet. He's big and his hits are even bigger. Here's a look at Kyle Rubish.
A beast on the field, but a beauty for the fans. There's many reasons why Kyle Rubish is one of the top defensemen in the National Lacrosse League.
He's just a big, strong guy. He makes contact a lot, and he tends to be able to push people around. He has natural strength. He is a physical player, but he's got a lot of skill and finesse as well.
The 30-year-old has honed his craft through 9 seasons of professional lacrosse.
I've always looked at it by taking each shift one at a time. It's so important in this league that every time you go on the floor, you have to be your best.
The Brampton, Ontario product was named the NLL's best defensive player 4 years in a row from 2012 through 2015, placing as a finalist in years since and is in the running once more.
In my mind, he's still the best D guy in the business. Great anticipation, you know, ability to pick off passes, and he has an incredible knack for being able to dislodge a ball from an opponent.
Now, Rubish has it. Rubish, waiting, scores!
Rubish currently leads the league on caused turnovers. He has 29 through the first 12 games this season. Rubish also set the NLL single season record of 61 in 2014.
I love the physical nature of the game. I love getting a big hit or a big slash or a big turnover. It's part of my game and something that I really like to do, obviously.
The assistant captain is also a league leader in loose ball scoops, surpassing 1,000 last year. Rubish is also known and loved for getting rough, but there's a soft side to this hard hitter.
And he's such a nice guy off the floor, so humble and does it, you know, day in, day out, and you think he would be like intense. He's not. He's happy-go-lucky and then just an absolute warrior. Just leads by example and puts a game in and game out.
Don't go anywhere, because after the break, we're going to show you some of the best moments from Saturday Night Lacrosse right here on Co-op Field. Plus,
the look on these kids' faces is just unbelievable.
Rush players share their love of lacrosse with kids during a special trip in northern Saskatchewan.
We come from a unique place where Lake Country could be your own backyard or hundreds of miles away. There's urban, suburban, country, proud. We are unique, and our networks are too. Built, owned, and operated with pride. These are your networks, Saskatchewan. We built something amazing, and 6 years of awards prove it. Over the next year, SaskTel is investing over $300 million into your networks to keep connecting you to what matters most.
Imagine, there I was eating lunch when suddenly I get this shooting pain. Turns out I needed a root canal. Thankfully, Blue Cross had my back.
If you're retired, self-employed, or don't have group insurance, you can count on Blue Cross. We provide coverage for many medical expenses that may not be fully covered by your provincial healthcare plan, like dental, prescription drugs, vision, registered therapists, and more. Visit our website or contact your insurance broker.
Hi, my name's Alex. I'm the TD Junior Reporter. How old were you when you started to play lacrosse?
I started to play lacrosse when I was about 7 years old, I believe.
What do you like about lacrosse?
I love playing the sport, but there's really nothing better than hanging out with a lot of your best friends and all playing together. That's a ton of fun.
What's your favorite flavor of ice cream?
I take heat for this one. I just like plain vanilla. I think there is something to be said for a great scoop of vanilla ice cream. What's your favorite ice cream flavor?
Cheesecake.
That's a good answer too.
Thanks.
It was a pleasure. There it is.
Thank you. Welcome to the 8th Street Co-op. We have some Rush players here. We have our brand new seasonal popcorn. It's green, it's cool, it's funky. And now let's see what flavors they can guess.
I think it's caramel apple.
I think it's just green apple, hence the green.
I mean, I got a copy, Benny, or I think it's caramel apple.
Were we right? Yeah, you were right. It is caramel apple. This is my favorite one.
Yeah.
This Benny's
good.
Got the cheese on that one.
Something cheese.
It's like a four. I guess bacon and cheese. It's like a cheese mix, I don't know, like a four cheese.
Ooh,
whatever, you know.
Different kinds of cheese. I don't know. I can't get past just the cheese. It's definitely cheese something.
Cheddar dill.
Cheddar dill.
Dill is your secret spice. Here we are in round three. The boys have had a couple of tastes. They think they have it figured out, but do they really?
Bacon cheese.
Rock cheese?
Yeah, definitely bacon. Definitely cheese.
Bacon and cheese, 100%.
Well, the boys got it right. It is bacon cheddar.
Defending champions, your Saskatchewan Rush, have been on top or near the top of the West Division all season long. After the loss in San Diego, they were again at 500. But with two road wins against Vancouver earlier this season, the Rush were ready to host the Warriors at home for their final meeting and a chance to clinch a playoff spot.
Fans came to party, they came to play. Goaltender Adam Shute gets the start once again, but look who's back. Rush Hulk has recovered from his own injury in time to welcome the Warriors. 3 minutes into the first.
Rush get their offense back on the floor. Matthews across for Church, has some room and scores. Robert Church opens the scoring for Saskatchewan.
Yeah, big one there for Robbie Church. It's just his 17th of the season for Churchy. He's been getting his chances, Ryan, all season long. Ball just hasn't really been falling the way it normally has for Church.
But a little foreshadowing for you. Oh, and how about this?
Off the bat turnover, big hit there from Felix.
Huge collision is Nick Felix with authority.
Also a sign of things to come.
Here on this power play, still a minute and a half in it. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Shot from Tegan Ball, and he finds the back of the net. And we're all tied at one.
All right, just gotta shrug it off.
The Rush look to go back in front here with this possession. Shatler with the shot, it's just wide. And now Church on the rebound, and he gets it past Penny. And the Rush are back out front, 2-1.
I tell you what, that's when Robert Church is at his best, when he's prowling around the top of the crease. Whether he's got the ball on his stick or he doesn't, he goes to the right spots on the floor. Shatler misses on the outside shot. Church didn't get boxed out by Ian Huxby, who pays for that one. And good patience there from 17.
Fans didn't have to be patient for this next one.
Shielded off from goal, but he still finds the net. What an effort. Bucket Ryan Keenan, and it's 3-1 Rush.
With the offense on fire, defense is holding it down. Three left in the first. Rush with the man advantage.
Matthews rather than Church with the first quarter hat trick. It's 5-1 Rush.
Oh, Bobby Church is feeling it tonight. And the Rush are rolling. Another power play goal. 2-for-2 now, and it's 5-1 Saskatchewan.
That's where we'll stay heading into the second. Saskatchewan starting things off.
Here are the Rush. Matthews in the middle, bounces one past Penny, and it's 6-1 for the Rush. Now McIntosh, he gets held high, but gets the ball into the net. Somehow, some way, Benny Matt makes it 7-1.
That was absolutely ridiculous from Benjamin McIntosh right there. Took a huge hit down to the crease. He did well just to catch the ball. Then Ray almost rides him into the turf. Somehow keeps the tippy toes out of the crease. And then bounces it low past Eric Penny to make it 7-1 Rush.
Eric Penny getting worked by the Rush.
Up top for Shatler, has a lane and scores. Jeff Shatler, it's his first of the evening. And the hole gets deeper for the Warriors.
After this one, the Warriors pull Penny and send in former Rush goaltender Aaron Bold.
That's going to draw a penalty, but on the delayed call, the Warriors finally stop the run. It's now 8-2.
Yeah, Jean-Luc Chandler found himself open, the rookie on the far side of the floor.
Saskatchewan, 10 seconds into their third power play.
Church with a shot, he scores top corner. Robert Church's fourth goal of the game. It's 9-2 Rush.
You're going to see the confidence meter on Robert Church start to skyrocket here with this first half performance. He's been waiting and waiting for a game like this.
Now an open lane for Shatler, who buries it. And we're at 10-2 for the Rush.
The Rush with their biggest lead this season. It's 10-2 heading into the half. Third quarter, a brand new attitude.
Still 6 games to go as that one trickles over the shoulder of Adam Shute and into the net. And the Warriors have their first goal here in this third quarter as they're back within 7.
But just as Jeremy Thompson wins the next faceoff.
And now we're going to have a fight as Nick Bjelic is dropping the gloves with Owen Parker. Bjelic goes for the first shot, can't land it now. Goes for the uppercut. Parker trying to come over the top. Bjelic trying to get a grasp. Both guys trying to land some shots. No one really has now. Parker gets a couple in on Bjelic, who winds up. And now Bjelic tees off on Owen Parker. Give that one to Nick Bjelic. T-K-O.
Listen to Rush Nation, Ryan Flaherty.
Both players receive 5-minute majors and leave the field. Owen Parker receives an additional 5-minute major for the initial hit on Thompson. But before that power play kicks in for the Rush, Warriors capitalize and tempers flare.
And now we're going to get another.
And Jeremy Thompson takes down his man in a full, almost a suplex there, just rolling him to the ground. It's Zach Porter and Porter. Thompson's still engaged here as Porter.
The fights are benefiting Vancouver. Thompson's penalty cancels out that power play for the Rush, who've yet to score this quarter.
5-on-5 lacrosse here with 3 minutes to go in the third. McIntosh fires and scores!
It's 11-5 Rush at the end of a feisty third quarter. In lacrosse, a 6-goal lead can be slippery. Nearly halfway into the fourth, Vancouver gets on a roll. Just under 30 seconds left, Shatler's empty netter nets the win. With more analysis, let's head to the BR Live broadcast booth.
Hello from Saskatoon as the Saskatchewan Rush defeat the Vancouver Warriors 12-9 on a Saturday night here at SaskTel Center. Ryan Flaherty alongside Jake Elliott, and it was a dominant first half performance by the Rush, and they seemingly had the ball all night.
Yeah, it really started with Jeremy Thompson, the faceoff dot, who went 19 for 24 in this game and just continually kept up coming with possession after possession. It's a game that Saskatchewan needed to win to punch their playoff ticket, and they did that here with a 12-9 victory, and that's who won and why.
Absolutely. The Rush clinched that playoff spot in the NLL West as they improved to 7-6 with the victory. As for the Warriors, who'd fall to 4-11 with the loss, they are swept in the season series with Saskatchewan.
Now we're going to have a fight as Nick Bjelic is dropping the gloves with Owen Parker.
He looked pretty good for a guy that was in a scrap filter tonight.
Yeah, I mean, no worse after that, so kind of happy about that. But at the same time, that's my roommate and my teammate, Jeremy, and the guy took a liberty on him. So seeing him on the ground like that is seeing like your family member or a brother on the ground. So no hesitation there, jump right in. And I'd expect anything else from anyone else on the team. So,
do you like that part of the game, or would you rather not do that part of the game? Do you have a feeling on that one or the other?
It's part of the game.
Yeah.
I mean, if guys are taking liberties on our players, then, you know, I'm going to back them up. I mean, I'm not the biggest guy. I'm not the strongest guy, but I'm going to be there for my teammates.
And you're in the playoffs now. Does that mean something?
Anything can happen in the playoffs.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing. I don't care if we slide in fourth, third, second, first. Doesn't matter. The best team at that moment's going to win, and I think we're coming together at the right time.
Some traditions are universal, like dreaming of the road ahead, the joy of arriving at your destination, and remembering the people you shared those moments with. We make sure those memories are clear, because no matter where life may take you, Glassmasters is part of your journey.
There are names here that go way back, building this community generation after generation. We are Mosaic, and we add our name to theirs to tell a story of innovation, of sustainability, of strength. Day after day, our commitment reflects our employees' efforts to create a legacy we can all share. Together, we can see tomorrow from here.
Sports definitely been growing since the Rush has come to town. That's no secret. It's brought a new attitude to all of Saskatchewan for lacrosse.
Oh!
It's been an amazing experience all around.
Five-liter turbo engine in here. Puts up 570 foot-pounds of torque.
Feel it.
So it's the same engine that's in the Ford Raptor. We're gonna put it into comfort mode. So it's like your quietest, smoothest, softest ride that you can have. So it's got the blind spot monitoring, so if you're not, can't see, it's gonna light up a light in the corner of the mirrors, let you know it's not safe to be changing lanes. It's also got lane keeping, lane departure warning, adaptive cruise control, collision warning, collision avoidance.
Massage chair or something else though. Lower back, just nice and warm too.
The Pro Trailer Backup Assist. That is one of the coolest features, and Lincoln and exclusive.
Backs it up for you?
It's like auto park for trailers. You measure the hitch and program the measurements into the dash. You want your trailer to go left, you just turn the control knob to the left. You want your trailer to go right, you turn it right, and it does all the steering for you so you don't oversteer, don't jackknife.
That's unbelievable, yeah.
A couple different sound settings. Right now we're set on stage, so it sounds like you're right on stage with the band. Now I just moved it to the audience, so it's gonna project the sound out more instead of surround it. So from the back seat, you can adjust the volume up and down, control your own temperature from the back.
Backseat DJ.
You got the heads up display, shows you right up in front through the windshield. Shows you through the windshield what your speed is, shows you your adaptive cruise control and everything.
I thought it was just a reflection or something for a second.
Lots of cool features, onboard Wi-Fi, cell phone app remote start, so you want to start your vehicle when you're getting off the lake, you just hit start on your phone.
Or from your house when it's minus 45 here.
That's right. Those lines will line up right with the lines on the pavement if we could see them.
Thanks for the ride. This
hey,
is,
you're welcome.
This is great. Quite a machine, and yeah, love to have one of these.
Being part of Rush Nation is about more than just watching great professional lacrosse. Saskatchewan fans show up with pride, passion, and big hearts to help make a difference for worthy causes at home and around the world.
Last week's home game helped benefit the incredible work of Operation Smile. The organization provides free and safe cleft lip and palate surgeries to children without access to treatment.
The magic with Operation Smile is that we have volunteers giving their time. Doctors, nurses, speech language pathologists, anesthesiologists, plus we have donors that are helping get that smile operation for a child. And if you take all of the donated goods that go into it, we've equated it to about a $240 operation.
After 36 years, Operation Smile has furthered its goal by empowering communities through technology.
We can take the equipment in and we can leave it there. All of a sudden, a community has a surgical room. All of a sudden, they have access to surgery for cleft lip and palate, and then maybe for eye, maybe for other facial conditions.
The need is still great for Operation Smile. The 12 Rush goals scored last week will help cover surgeries for 12 children. Proceeds from the sale of mini bruisers were also donated, along with $7,500 from the Saskatchewan Lacrosse Association.
All I can say is, wow, thank you, Rush, and the fans that are coming out.
Are we ready?
Rush Nation also came together before the game for a special spin and yoga event.
Once you got the beat, move it up here.
Benefiting Operation Smile.
We are turning up the heat. Are we feeling good? All right, how about now? Come on down. Let's go! 12 more seconds. Come with us, come with us. Turn it up again. Go, go, go. Here's that final push. We're going up. At it.
Take this moment to pause. Feel this work you've done, not just to ride, to stretch, to breathe, but to also create this small little moment of quietness in your day. To share community, to share your practice, to share your breath.
This is what we call Ardha Hanumanasana. Just go a little further.
Thank you so much for sharing your practice. The light in me honors the light and the divinity within you. Namaste.
The Rush would like to thank everyone who has helped make a difference this season. Recently, Rush players Mark Matthews and Zach Gould had the pleasure of visiting two schools in northern Saskatchewan. With Rush partner NextGen Energy, the players shared their stories and their love of lacrosse with kids in Turner Lake and Buffalo Narrows.
We got the announcement that a rusher coming in. Us staff, we were excited.
Hey everyone, I'm Mark Matthews. This is Zach Gould. We play for the Saskatchewan Rush. I like to start with picking the ball up. I mean, it's a lot like shoveling snow, and it's kind of what I use to explain it. We're gonna shovel right through. Who wants to try first?
From nursery all to grade 12, the kids participated, and that's huge. Just to see athletes of that caliber to come here and do a few drills with the kids. It's phenomenal and exciting, and it's great to see.
The look on these kids' faces, just unbelievable how excited they are, and they just want to pick up a stick and just start going.
Most of the time, I always think that nobody has a clue who we are or what we're doing here, but you know, when stuff like this happens where, you know, they got signs up everywhere and stuff outside, it's pretty cool, and they obviously know that we're coming and what we are and what we're doing.
The communities that we work within and we work around are very important to us. So anything we can bring up to the community is something different, something for the kids. Especially the focus on the youth is education, health and wellness. And our partnership with the Rush, it's enabled us to do that simply by showing them another sport.
2, 3.
I've never been this far north, and it's just unbelievable to see the community up here and how tight-knit they are, and the great kids and the teachers up here and this fantastic schools that we've got to visit.
Some of the young girls, like the grade 5s and grade 4s, were pretty good. And they're having fun, like I said, the smile on their face, and they're running around, and you know, I get to throw the ball at you know, at one of their teachers or something in the net. It also adds a little bit to that.
But for the entire school, I would like to present your principal with a team signed Saskatchewan Rush jersey. And NextGen Energy, they're the reason that we're here today, and they are the ones who made this possible. So thank you, NextGen, and I want to thank you guys so much for allowing us to be here today and welcoming us in your community.
It's fabulous to see the kids, the school, the teachers, everyone embrace what we're bringing up here. For the kids to get to enjoy guys like Mark Matthews to come up and hang out and play with them, that's something special.
A big thanks to NextGen Energy for making that trip possible. Your Saskatchewan Rush are in Denver tonight to face the Colorado Mammoth. You can catch all the action on BR Live. Next week is also a busy one for the boys, who are back in San Diego Friday, only to return home the next day for a first-time meeting against the Philadelphia Wings.
This one's for you, Rush Nation. Saturday, April 13th is Fan Appreciation Night, co-presented by SaskTel and the University of Saskatchewan. Enjoy happy half hour with $5 beer from 6 to 6:30, along with 20% off Rush merchandise at the arena. Rush season tickets are also now on sale. As a thank you for 5 fantastic years in Saskatchewan, every season ticket holder for 2019-2020 will receive a 5th anniversary collector's jersey. It's one jersey for every seat. Get your tickets today at saskrush.com.
Thanks for watching this episode of Rush TV. Until next time, I'm Daniella Ponticelli. Go Rush, go!